Good morning, my dear students. Here we are discussing types of the power semiconductor switches. So here, power semiconductor switches, the first one is diode. It will be having the symbol of like this. That means it will be having the anode and cathode, symbol like this. Thyristor. Thyristor is a family. It will be consist of some devices. So thyristors. SCR. First one is SCR. Of course, in depth we will see later, but listen here. SCR, silicon control rectifier. Silicon control rectifier, anode, cathode, and of course here the one gate term will be there. And it's LJSCR. LJSCR means light activated SCR. Light activated SCR in this one, anode, cathode, gate. Here light activated SCR means here you can observe the light also, light symbol. And next one is ACR or RCT, asymmetrical SCR. ACR means asymmetrical SCR, RCT, reverse conducting thyristor. Here anode, cathode, gate, that means in addition to thyristor, okay, in addition to thyristor, one diode will be anti-parallel, okay, one diode will be anti-parallel, that is nothing but ACR or RCT. Next, GTO, gate turn off thyristor. Gate turn off thyristor symbol is like this. Next, SITH, static induction thyristor. Static induction thyristor symbol is like this. Next, MCT, mass controlled thyristor. MCT means metal oxide semiconductor controlled thyristor. The symbol is like this. And next, TRIAC. TRIAC, here you can observe that MT1 and MT2, and here it is the gate. Okay, MT1, MT2, and here it is the gate you can observe. In depth, we'll see later. Next, transistors. Coming to transistors, first one is bipolar junction transistor. Bipolar junction transistor. Here there will be of two types of the transistors, NPN and PNP. NPN and PNP will be having the terminals, common, base and emitter, all you know. And next, MOSFET, n-channel MOSFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. A MOSFET full form is that one, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Drain, source and gate will be there. Static induction thyristor. Static induction thyristor. Here this is this one. And SIT, same shortcut is SIT. IGBT, insulated gate bipolar transistor. Collector, emitter and gate will be there. Coming to classification of a switches. So ideal switches, there will be of the two types. One is ideal switch and one is practical switch. Now we will see what are the characteristics and what is meant by that one, ideal switch and practical switch, we'll see now. So ideal switch. Coming to ideal switch, what is meant by ideal switch means it will be on whenever it has been on, then automatically there will be a finite amount of the, okay, then automatically there will be a finite amount of the current will be there. And of course the drop, voltage drop will be during the on stage, voltage drop will be zero. And it's during the off position. During the off position, the current will be zero. And of course voltage will be some limited. That is the ideal switch characteristics. Next, these are the characteristics you can observe. Here in the diagram, whenever V is on, okay, whenever time is on, then automatically switch has been closed. Okay, then automatically switch has been closed. Then if the switch is closed, then current will be some limited. Okay, current will be going, current will be started, current will be started like this, current will be started. And if this current is in the on position, then what about the voltage? There will be no voltage drop. That means there is no drop of the voltage. So that's why here drop is at the zero only. You can observe here. Whenever switch has been on, then there will be a current. And at the same time, voltage will be zero. And of course, there will be no transition time. So that's why time will be automatically same. Then during the off position, okay, then during the off position, current will be automatically zero during the off position, during the off of the switch position, during the off of the switch position, current will be zero. At the same time, whatever the voltage, voltage will be maximum, okay, voltage will be maximum, same, then the same consequence will be happen. During this one, what is the power? Okay, during this one, what is the power? So you can observe during the on stage, that means from this point to this point, what will be the current is maximum, but voltage is voltage drop will be zero, so that's why power is at the zero position I have written. And next, at the same time, next during the off position, during the off position, current is at the zero position but voltage is at the some maximum position, then automatically here the power will be the multiplied by P is equal to V into I. Okay, P is equal to V into I, by multiplying those two we can get zero. These are the ideal switch characteristics. Next, coming to the practical switch. If you know, if you go for practical switch, what about that one? Whenever it is on, okay, whenever it is on, there will be V on, there will be current, it will be flow. Okay, current will flow. First of all, whenever switch is in on, current will be flow. But here, current will be under the limitations of the minimum current and maximum current. Some limitations will be there during the practicals for the practical switch. At the same time, what about the voltage? There will be a slight voltage drop will be there. So that's why voltage will not be zero. Please remember this one. We will see by means of diagram also. And during the off position, current will be automatically, should be zero, but it should not, it will be not be zero, slightly current will be there. So that's why I of not is equal to zero I have written during the operation. And of course voltage will be something, and what will be something, that something is nothing but I have written it should be under the limits of minimum and maximum, in which way we'll see. Practical switch characteristics. What are the practical switch characteristics? Just now we have observed that during the on position, okay, during the on position, there will be a current, compulsory there will be a current, but that current will be under the limitations of minimum and maximum current. So that's why here the current is somewhat will be there. And at the same time, during the on position, wherever the current is there, but here voltage completely not is equal to zero. So that's why here there is a slight drop, okay, slight drop of the voltage will be there during the on position. And next, here whenever during the off position, okay, during the off position current will be somewhat drop, somewhat will be there, but voltage is at the some limitations, okay, according to our previous discussion. These are the characteristics. And at the same time, what about the power here? During the on position, current will be like this and voltage will be like this. Power will be also slight will be there. And at the same time, off position. What are the off position? This is the off position, current will be there. And these are the voltage will be there. At the same time, power will be like this. So next one is ideal case terms. That means whenever we are discussing ideal switches and practical switches, some terms will be there, we need to remember. So ideal case terms, what are those terms means? First one is switching time. What is mean by switching time is nothing but the time taken, okay, the time taken to change the state from the on state to the off state, or off state to the on state. Time taken to change the state from on state to the off state to the on state is called switching time. So here you can observe that here this is the switching time taken from to change from on state to the off state, or off state to the on state. So here for the ideal case the switching time is equal to zero. Okay, for the ideal case, the switching time is equal to zero. You can observe in the diagram. Next, coming to the power loss. There will be of the two types of the losses will be the first one is conduction loss and second one is switching loss. So here, what is meant by conduction loss means the loss is present when the switch is in the on state position. Then automatically one loss will be there, that is nothing but conduction loss. For the ideal case, this conduction loss is equal to zero. Here you can observe that the power will be is equal to V into I. Okay, V into I. So here current is there, but voltage will be zero. So that's why power will be zero. So which is nothing but that power loss is equal to zero. Conduction loss is equal to zero. For the ideal case, conduction loss is equal to zero. And next, switching loss. What do you mean by switching loss? The time taken to turn on and turn off. Okay, the time taken to turn on and turn off is called switching loss. Here also you can observe that ideal case. For the ideal case, the time taken for switching on, here it is on. Okay, here it is on. And next, it is off. Okay, it is on and off. On and off at the same position they are coming. So that's why this is the switching loss. Okay, switching loss is equal to 0 in the case of the ideal. Coming to the practical terms. What is meant by switching time? Okay, what is meant by switching time? The time taken to turn on and turn off. Okay, the time taken to turn on and turn off can be called as the switching time. So here for the practical case, okay, for the practical case, switching time is equal to T is equal to T on, okay, T on plus T off. You can observe that here it is a on time, okay, it is a on time, but here it is going for the off period, okay, it is going for the off period. So that's why this can be considered as T off and this can be considered as T on. So that's why both by combining these two, okay, by combining these two, T on and T off, then that will be called as the switching time. Next, power loss. What is meant by power loss? Power loss, conduction, there will be here also two types. One is conduction loss and another one is switching loss. What is meant by conduction loss? Power loss during the on state. Okay, power loss during the state. Power loss during the state can be called as the conduction loss. That means the loss which is present when the switch is in the on position. When the switch is in the on position, the loss will be there. Here you can observe that this conduction loss, here the current is at this time on position, voltage is at this time. What about the power? Here it is nothing but this loss. Whatever may be the this loss we are getting at this stage, that is nothing but your conduction loss. Okay, that is nothing but your conduction loss. And it's switching loss. What do you mean by switching loss? During the T on and T off. Okay, during the T on and T off can be called as the switching loss. So here the switching loss is nothing but from the on position to off position, it is going to change. Voltage is changing this like this, and the current is changing like this. So that's why this loss, okay, whatever may be the this loss here we are observing at this point, that loss can be called as the switching loss. You can remember.